horizontal stretches and compressions. I'm just going to write down where this happens. Y equals F of C times X inside the grouping symbols of the function notations, where C is greater than 0. So I want to point out, make sure you have in your notes, multiply inside the grouping symbols by a positive number. Now, we have to think this through carefully, and seeing the example will help you understand why. But the action taking when you have C on the inside of the grouping symbols is multiply the X values of the key points or the anchor points by 1 over C. In other words, the reciprocal of C. So kind of like when we did the horizontal shifts, we did the opposite of what the simplified operation looked like inside the grouping symbols. We're going to do the opposite of what looks like multiplication, and that we're actually dividing by C, but we're going to say multiply by the reciprocal, which is the same as dividing by C. But we're going to go ahead and stick with that verbiage so that we see we have the two cases. If C is greater than 1, strictly greater than positive 1, this is a compression. And although this won't make sense quite yet, when we see exact concrete example, it'll show you why this is a compression in the horizontal direction. And we call it a compression by a factor of 1 over C. Now, if we have C between 0 and 1, this is actually a stretch in the horizontal direction. So it's a stretch by a factor of 1 over C. Now remember, we're going to multiply by 1 over C. So if C is actually a fraction, the reciprocal of a fraction, a number between 0 and 1, is actually a larger number. So the X value will increase. So for horizontal, what happens here? A stretch makes the graph wider in the horizontal direction, and a compression makes the graph narrower or more narrow in the horizontal direction. The key thing here is we're speaking horizontally. All right, so now let's look at our absolute value function with a couple of horizontal compressions and stretches. So we have our parent graph is the V-shaped curve. Y equals the absolute value of X. Our three anchor points or key points, 0, 0, 1, 1, and negative 1, 1. What happens when we use blue this time? When we have a number greater than 1 on the inside of the absolute value symbols, in other words, y equals the absolute value of 2 times x. Well, if c is greater than 1, we're going to multiply by 1 over C. So we're going to multiply all the X values by 1/2. So when I multiply 0 times 1/2, I just get 0. So I'll have 0. And we're not doing anything to the Y. So I have the origin in the graph of Y equals the absolute value of 2x. When I look at 1, 1, the x value is 1, so I'm multiplying it by 1 half. But my y value is going to still be 1, so I have 1 half 1. And likewise, when I multiply negative 1 by 1 half, I get negative 1 half, and then I don't do anything to the y value. So I have shown that when we have y equals the absolute value of 2 times x, I've made the graph more narrow. So that is a horizontal compression. It shrinks it in the horizontal direction, but it looks like the shape has gotten more narrow. Now let's choose a C. Just go ahead and choose different color here. That's a number between 0 and 1, so we'll just use 1 half again, but the important thing here is the 1 half is operating on the x inside the absolute value symbol. So once again, our origin has not moved. We'll still have the origin because multiplying the x value of 0 times 1 over 1 half, which is really just multiplying by 2, just gives us 0, 0 again. But now when I take the x value of 1 and I multiply it by 1 over 1 half, I multiply by the reciprocal of 1 half, so that gives me 2, 1. So let's say that again. I'm going to take the x value of 1 and I'm going to multiply it by 1 over 1 half. So that's just 1 times 2, so that equals 2. And then likewise, taking negative 1 times 1 over 1 half just gives me negative 2. See, I'm kind of in the way here. We'll just put my negative 2 right there. Negative 2. I don't do anything to the y value. So as you can see, SEE, when C is a number between 0 and 1, we have taken the graph and stretched it in the horizontal direction so it looks wider.